questions and can we check this actually? Okay.
Can you tell me them in advance so I can?
Yeah, I'll ask you and I'll read them to you now. Okay, so the questions that LZ wanted me to ask, I'm going to ask you, what's special about the cultural resources in Lowell? Why do more kids need access to the arts in our city? And in your personal opinion, what makes our community ready to do an arts expansion project in our schools right now? What makes our community ready to do an arts expansion project in our schools right now? I'll read the questions just so we can have them on film. John, what do you think is special about the cultural resources here in Lowell?
Well, that's a great question, because I think that over the last 20, 30 years, Lowell has really adopted and developed its basis in the creative economy and the promotion of arts and culture in general, particularly bringing lots of artists to Lowell over the last 20 years. There's a lot to do, and as I say, there's a lot to like about Lowell. But I think that the special role that Lowell plays in this is that both its proximity to Boston, to the fact that it's encouraged arts and culture as a way of developing the economy, has made it a crucible, if you like, of art and culture in the region. And that's a very special place, it seems to me.
Yes. And why do more kids need access to the arts in our city, would you say?
Again, as a professor, I'm a teacher, and I've been working in Lowell around these issues for a long period of time. You know, a lot of what we talk about with educating kids is getting them through tests, getting them to understand science and technology, but the real reason that I think it's important to promote arts and culture in schools and for children and for kids and for all of us for that matter is that exposure to culture and to art promotes creativity, it promotes innovation, it makes people understand that there is more to the world than they would expect. As a teacher, especially a teacher of political science, I can tell you that there is more truth in a poem or a play or a performance or a painting than in 1,000 textbooks in political science. And we need to make sure that young people recognize that, get exposed to it, if we want to have a population which is creative and smart and tolerant and thoughtful, and the only way that happens is through exposure to art and culture.
Right. And what do you think makes our community ready to do an arts expansion project in our schools right now?
I think partly goes back to my prior answers. One is that Lowell is this center for arts and culture, and so it's a great place to develop an experiment in thinking about how students can gain more from involvement in arts and culture. Secondly, because I believe very, very passionately that this is really the only way we think about educating our children. They can learn more through this process than any other way we can give them knowledge about the world. We certainly don't give them knowledge by simply testing them on scientific or empirical facts.
Mm.
And we're at a point where we've got the infrastructure in place in Lowell because of what we've done around culture and arts development for the community as a whole. And schools are at a point where I think we're beginning to realize that a good education is not simply an education in the basics or in testing those basics, but a good education to create the kind of individuals that will succeed at work and develop our economy, and more importantly perhaps, create a society worth living in, that this is a moment in time when those students need to be engaged with knowledge of art, practitioners of art, and by art I mean everybody, including writers and musicians, as well as the visual artists, and a chance for them to see who those people are, what they do, how they think about the world, and what art and culture has done to change the world, most often in a very positive direction. So that's why I think we're actually right at that point where bringing this kind of activity into our classroom, to exposing kids more directly to, as I say, both the practitioners and the value of art, can create a potential for a much better education system and much better educated students.
Great. That's great.
Okay.
Thank you so much. I think we have everything we need.
Okay, I didn't.
No.
I'm going to lay it out on the
Yeah, of course.
2 seconds.